kupembeza kupembeza dzinzarese dzinzarese rotutuba budiriro yako ndedo iwe musukuru kanondo onesa wira wotambeko wazvinzvaka iwe wandinzvaka
The old tale of little Cindy Lera who became queen has almost become a cliche, but the game of football has continued to resurrect the Cinderella tale day in, day out. Besides silky skills on the soccer pitch, incredible goals and glittering football careers, the common factor found in Pele, Ronaldo, Ronaldinho and other stars from Brazil is that they all grew up in poverty and were given a lifeline by the beautiful game. There is not much in common between Brazil and Zimbabwe, yet the football gods can still pen a script which fits both Harare and Sao Paulo. This is not Bauru, the Brazilian poor town where Pele grew up. This is Mbare, Harare's oldest suburb. To others, Mbare is infamous, for poverty stinks in Mbare and vice reigns supreme. But this is also home of the heroes in Zimbabwean sport. Two-time Commonwealth boxing champion Zwenyika Rifonso hails from Mbare. Many of Zimbabwe's great footballers also come from this poverty-stricken suburb. For a visitor to Zimbabwe to return to his home country without setting foot in Mbare is like going to the Netherlands and never seeing any windmill, or visiting France yet never seeing the Eiffel Tower. For they say if you have been to Zimbabwe and never been to Mbare, then you never really came to Zimbabwe, even as the local informal Shona adage that has been coined by the locals say, kwaenda Mbare, ndo kwaenda Harare, kwaenda Harare, ndo kwaenda Mbare. Right in the heart of Mbare is probably the poorest part of this old suburb, Matapi Flats. If Mbare is poor, then Matapi Flats probably represents poverty personified. But this is where little midfield dynamo in Zimbabwean soccer, Achford Gutu, grew up.
I grew up here with my mom. And I started staying here with my mom and my daddy and my little sister Nyarachi. And my father passed away when I was in grade 6. I started staying with my mom, and my mom couldn't afford to pay me school fees to go to school. So I went to play soccer, so then I got a scholarship from Sporting Academy to help this team. So Sporting paid all my fees from Form 1 up to Form 4, because my mother couldn't afford to get the money to pay for the school fees. Actually, my mother died. She was a maid in Acadia, so she couldn't afford to pay me school fees. But Sporting did that for me. I'm very happy so that I came up to Oshawa. It was so hard growing up in Mbare because there are a lot of, they say this is the thief area, but I grew up here. It's a nice area. The people here, they've got talent, but they don't have something to come out of their shell so that somebody can see the heart of Mbare. I think Mbare, there's talent in Mbare. Mbare is always my home, I say, because I grew up here, I came from here. So that's why I always come back here to see people here.
As can be gone from the background, noise typifies the daily life in Mbare. Just like Pele, Ronaldo and Ronaldinho, Gutu grew up steeped in poverty and played the plastic ball in the dusty streets of what some might call a slum.
Yeah.
Just next door to Matapi Flats is Rufaro Stadium, affectionately known as Zimbabwe's ceremonial home of football. Rufaro, a Shona word for happiness or joy, is home ground to Dynamo's football club. Dynamo's nickname, Dimbare, is derived from the name of this old township. Dynamos is the most popular and most successful club in Zimbabwe, with 18 league titles since its formation in 1963. This is the club that gave Archford Gutu a home to display his talents to the world and graduate him to the No More Plastic Balls platform. If Zimbabweans love Gutu, then Dynamo supporters worship him. Known to them simply as Uche, after a Nigerian star, Gutu is a darling to those in Mbare. They see him as one of their own. The difference is that the football gods smiled on Uche and penned a beautiful song, From the Dust to the Throne, a typical Cinderella tale. At 19, Archford Gutu looks like one of the luckiest boys to emerge from a third world African country by securing a place in the elite European leagues. But for Uche, as he is affectionately known by thousands of Zimbabwean football supporters, his strike on gold is not by mere luck, but a result of hard work and serious commitment. Uche's story is a tale of magical exploits that leaves many gasping for breath whenever he takes off to the field of play. He is an envy of his mates and a heartbreak to his opponents.
Osim zuwa apa nisinga once little Sisara in town.
Basically, I can say actually it is someone who is very fun. It was fun. We grew up together, living in Mbare. He was my best friend. We used to play chikwesh. Yeah. We used to play chikwesh when we were very young. As we grew, he was someone who was just like, he was talented. His strength basically is very powerful. And he's got a big heart. He doesn't care, he's playing who, big names, even plays. So our parents took us to go to church. Basically, that separated us from Mbare. We live in Mbare, but we are not from Mbare because we are church goers. We want to do something which is nice, like keep away from drugs, being safe from those things, prostitution, everything, sort of things like that. But basically, I believe that is what made actually be successful, because he was free from drugs, free from prostitution, things like that.
But Gutu's story can never be complete without the mention of a man called Calvin Nyazema.
We started a project of going to the underprivileged communities, finding young boys with talent, and taking them out of those communities and putting them in a place where we believed was conducive for their development. We were looking at players with soccer talent mainly. So we started this in 2005. We had a group. Things didn't turn out as we had expected, and we continued until we met Ashford in 2006 at a playground, a bare playground, playing with his friends. We noticed them, that they were talented, him and about four friends. And naturally, we had to go and talk to their parents. At the time, his father had passed away, and he only had his mom who was surviving, but she already was not feeling well. So we went and spoke to him, to her, and we told our project, and we had to move him schools from Mbare, where he grew up. We had an arrangement with Cranbourne Boys High, where we'd take all the boys to Cranbourne Boys High. And from what we saw, what I saw with the team that I was working with, scouting for talent, Ashford and one boy were one of them who we believe were the most talented. And when we saw where he stayed and the conditions, he became our priority to move him away from there first.
His efforts to convert more sportsmen from Gutu's neighborhood has had severe resistance, with many boys relapsing back into their old lives of vice.
For the 5 years that we have done this at a serious scale since 2006, the numbers that we have had and tried to recruit, I would talk of more than 50. And out of that 50 that we have tried to recruit, the ones that we can really talk about are probably 12 to 15. The rest have gone back. Unfortunately, I couldn't mention, but some of them were there where we were standing. Some of them are taking drugs right there. They're still there. They either go back home, or when we take them, they don't pitch up for training, even though we are funding their bus fare. They don't come for training, or they come. There's another boy as well. We had gone back to his ways, but we went back in 2008, and in January, I personally went to his house. And I spoke to him and he came back.
Many are wishing the young footballer a bright future, hoping Gutu's presence in the elite European League will be a continuation of the road to glory and gold that he has been granted opportunity to embark upon.
If you look at most of the guys his age, most of the guys he played along, his age groups, I can say that most of them, if you look at them right now in Mbare, it's a different story. It's a different story. The life they're living, you know, the thug life, the drug life, drinking life, you know, that kind of life. Most of them, that's the life they're living. I only wish him the best, you know. I've always wished him the best since he started playing soccer. I've always wished him the best, and I still wish him the same.
If champions are never born but instead created, then Zimbabwe created a champion of their own in Gutu, who joins the bandwagon of other football notables like Knowledge Musona in the Bundesliga, Benjani Mwaruwaru in the Premier League, or Vidi Karuru in the French League. From what many have witnessed so far, there is consensus that Uche is carving a niche for himself in the annals of Zimbabwean football. While Uche's story might be your average rags-to-riches story, where football has turned many a poor boy into an instant millionaire, the question is, how far can football continue churning out positive testimonies from the ghetto?
The happiest moment of my life when I signed the contract with Parma FF, because it was always my dream to play in Europe when I was a kid. Now I'm very happy so that I'm going there.
And what can you promise if you go to Europe? What can you promise? Are we going to see the fire that we have always seen in Ashford Tutu?
I know Europe there is very tough, but I just think I have to go here from Africa there so that I'll get there, I'll work hard by myself so that I can maybe move from Sweden to a better league, maybe championship in England or La Liga in Spain. That's my
Honestly, we don't want to make more.